Creeper Con.
Owen
Verley.
Verley.
Put me on the picture.
Yeah. And how long are you driving the car?
Me, 52 years.
How old are you? Hello. You like the music?
Oh, we cannot look at that.
You like the music?
Oh, no.
No?
The music is very bad.
What kind of music do you like?
Pam?
What kind of music do you like?
No music at all.
Sure, there now.
I can't hear it.
Expect to see you tonight. Where are you from?
Holland.
How long are you in Ireland?
1 week.
And you enjoyed yourself?
Yes, very much.
Yeah, lovely weather. Yeah, we've been to the castle also, yes.
Are you looking forward to this festival?
Oh yes.
We chose it because of the lake, because it was in the center of the region where we wanted to stay.
Were you here before?
No, never.
Come back to France, we'll come back.
We come from Paris.
This the sky's up.
For the festival. This tradition. And I'm going to tell you my name now.
Is this what you wear every day?
That's what I wear every day. A new breed of cigarette that was brought out in the Inchigill. Not bad.
Yeah, can I have a gun?
What is your name?
Declan Gibbons Cobb.
Maureen O'Hara's shawl in the car. What am I supposed to do with it? Anya, will you get the white shawl in the car, please?
Thanks, Judah.
How you doing, Anya?
Are you looking forward to the festival?
Oh, I'm looking forward to the night. Get a bit of crack.
Are you taking part of it?
No, not really. We're just going down. We're just tourists-like, so we'll see if the crack is.
Where are you from?
Armagh. County Armagh.
And when did you come down here?
3 days ago.
Je ne comprends pas. Vous êtes English?
English.
Française.
France?
Ouais.
One man by the name of Thomas Tiernan.
How are you out here in Cork?
Oh, we're very well now. I just came out from Baden over here for this big parade that's taking place here today at the opening of the festival. And here on my right is Paddy McTighig. Hold on a second. There's a flash of pony here, please. Yeah, look at this flash of pony.
All right. You doing any trashing?
Oh, Jesus.
Yes, Charlie, with you. I love trash.
You mean?
Where are you from?
Carnacon.
Are you going dancing?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Johnson.
You've got that to do.
Yeah.
And where are you from?
Minamadi.
And what are you doing over here?
I had a bit of life over here.
Yeah. Are you the man that's growing grass?
I'm after the blight.
Oh, blight?
Yeah. Yeah, he's doing all the spraying in the west of Ireland at the moment.
Have you a job to get the bluestone?
Ashford Castle now with a bit of light around. Ashford Castle. Clincarab is a report that came in on Galway Bay FM that was blight in Clincarab.
Very badly hit with blight.
Yes.
Carla, what talk?
Is your potatoes good this year, Mr. Morton? Have you had much protection on them?
Oh, the bad.
Yeah. Have you got dogs?
Are the crows attacking?
Not yet.
The worst on the clothes.
Rebecca Munro.
And you've got nothing?
Yes.
And who's with you?
Oh my God.
should use some more.
What's your name?
Nicole.
You got that tattoo?
Yeah.
Who are you?
Mrs. Monroe.
Are these your daughters?
You got yours.
What is your name?
This is Barry Fitzgerald.
And where did you steal the horse?
I stole the horse back in Connemara.
And where did you get the, where did you get that gentleman now in the cart there?
That gentleman, well, I found him in the
Neckers yard. I thought they were extinct.
Oh, geez, they're not.
Oh, look.
We revived them again this year.
Easy, boss. Come back.
Yeah.
Martina.
Where are you from?
French.
What part of it?
No speak English.
You enjoying yourself?
Name?
My wife.
Friend?
What's your name?
Vivian.
And who do you represent?
Mellet's Poland, the name.
And are you going to win the Queen of the...
It's not winning the counts, it's just participating.
What's your name?
Malvina.
And where are you from?
Cross.
Do you want to win?
Yeah, I don't think so now. Gillian has a better chance.
Karen Malahi.
And who do you represent?
O'Connor's. Oh, my God.
Do you want to win?
I hope so.
Are you looking forward to the festival?
Yeah, looking forward to it.
You may want the teddy bears. Are you looking forward to the parade?
I do, I need my bag.
You already got us.
Caroline!
No. Hey!
You're running.
Okay,
Morris.
What did you
win?
Huh? What did you win the gold medals for?
I'm running.
What distance?
600 metres and 100 metres.
Ashley Cannon.
Where are you from?
Ballinrobe.
What part of the band? What do you play in the band?
I'm the bass.
You wrote that? You're living in.
Right now.
What's your name? What did you win the medal for?
For racing. Anya.
Your name?
Joanne.
And you step up front?
Yes.
Were you cutting turf in the barn?
No, saving the hay.
Are you expecting bad weather with the weldings?
Oh, well, you wouldn't know. You have to be prepared, like. You wouldn't know.
And what do you think of this parade?
Ah, sure. We'll tell you that when it's over.
It's more even fine.
What's Scully.
Where are you from?
Bart, County Galway.
Are you looking forward to the threshing here?
Oh, yes. I know all about those old machines. I followed them in a young fella.
Did you do much threshing?
I did, yeah. I thrashed with those. The high nilly, they call them.
Did you ever thrash with steam?
No, not with steam. I thrashed with the old high nilly, TVO, and a 35-inch dab with threshing engine, threshing mill.
Are you looking forward to this festival?
That's right, I am, yeah. Bring back old memories.
You come down especially for it?
Well, no, not. I was just passing through. We were out in Achille Island for the last week, and we just came down this way, down the Delphi Pass, down the Duluth Valley, and we was going to go through Mayam, and we changed our mind, we said we'd come through Kong.
So, are you glad you were right in Kong?
I am, delighted. Because I know all this old machinery, I'm older than you think.
You got burnt.
How did it get burnt?
Makeup. Okay, it's makeup.
Imagine, if you will. Once upon a time, the South American land iguana feed on the great quantities of seaweed beneath the surface of the water.
What are you? Do you want to give me a at all?
Yep.
Yeah.
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 Been around?
It is. Oh, you're around for it.
Are you looking forward? Yeah. Is John Wayne around?
Yes.
Are you taking over?
I'm taking over now.
Yeah. It's a quiet man, it's quite as the.
That's right, it's quite in me. Yeah.
Dave Lachlan, are
you going racing?
Oh, I am. I'm going to win too. Definitely.
I'm back.
All right.
Are you going to this race?
I am. I got the winners.
Flail. It was a weapon that was used long before the thrasher. It was for thrashing the seed. Protect the seed out of the shade.
Was it for anything else, like?
Pardon?
Was for anything else?
Well, no, unless a road start now, I'd say, could use it, you know. But now it's not licensed for a road.
Was it now?
No, it was solar for slashing.
Would it be great?
Yeah, definitely. Got the weather for it, no. I am.
She's gorgeous.
How are you?
Hi, Mum.
This is my belly. This is my belly.
Famous rat belly.
This is my tail.
Who are you?
I'm Claire.
And you like the rat?
Hmm?
You like the rat?
I love the rat. I love the rat.
Who is it?
Stand up.
Behave! God's sake, I can't bring you anywhere, can I? You're always upstaging me! Behave! God!
Yes,
I'm telling your mother!
I'm
telling your mother on you!
Peace!
Where did you get the drums?
It's mine. Don't pop there.
Are these fellas peaceful?
Look in here.
Don't annoy them. Are they cross?
Don't annoy them. Don't annoy them, I tell you.
Must be old.
Nice to meet you. Hello.
How did you get so tall?
I eat my greens.
Sweetabix,
monsters in.
Wave.
Michael. Yes.
joined the parade.
Hello, yes, lovely.
Today.
Yes, it's very nice. But we are not natives.
Where are you from?
Austria.
How did you get over here?
Oh, by plane. It's our last evening in Ireland.
Join the parade.
Don't wait.
Enjoying yourself.
Down in the village now, and we get them in the public houses afterwards. Well,
yes, you are. Yes,
normal.
What's the worry of the peg on the garage?
It's all right. Quite all right.
See Kong having Halloween, eh? Good fun.
Are you enjoying yourself? Enjoying the festival?
Yes. Pretty place.
Thanks. What's your name?
Eileen. Or Helen.
Greg Rex, look at the camera.
Where are you from?
Balea, Dublin.
Are you enjoying the festival?
Delhi.
Amelia.
Are you enjoying the festival?
No. We're waiting for the music to start.
There's no festival in the
room. Oh, there is, yeah. Not next weekend. Big band over there. And I'm being kind to the haymaker.
And then there's a free beer over there.
Oh yeah, always.
And where did I get free beer?
No man is. No man is beer in Cornamuna.
Yes, beer. What do you think about the free beer?
Oh, it's very good. Very enjoyable.
Are you giving the free beer?
Oh yeah, we get the free beer in Cornamuna from this man.
What about these big fellas out here when you get the drink?
What's that?
Out there, will you get him a drink?
I don't know yet what's going to happen. We'll have to wait and see.
Oh, there's a person
inside. What? A few drinks later now will be all the better.
You miss Dublin?
Yes, I do. Big time.
What's your name?
That's Elaine. What's your name? Say hello.
Are you afraid of the monsters?
Say hello.
Hello.
Are you afraid of the monsters?
Yeah. She won't say much. No?
Declan!
Oh, right.
Have you enjoyed this festival?
Yes, very good.
Where are you from?
Leeds.
Leeds?
Yeah.
How long were you waiting?
Not really.
Do you come to the festival every year?
I do, yeah.
You enjoying it?
Yeah, great.
I think. Amanda.
Amanda.
Yes, you already introduced me.
Oi, I'm 11.
I'm 10. I'm 11. So there's my mom.
Get my mom here. Get my mom.
Get Nana.
Oh, Calm down.
Enjoying the festival. Enjoying the festival.
Yeah. Yeah.
You come to Calm Down.
How do we have every weekend?
You come to Calm Down. Enjoying the festival.
Fantastic.
You're coming tomorrow.
Yes, we love the dancing.
Where are you from?
We're from the north.
What part of it?
Port of Down.
You come down with your oven?
No, first time. But not the last.
Come back again?
Yes. Yes, definitely.
Where are you going home?
Tomorrow.
Where tomorrow?
We've been here 2 weeks.
Good.
So this is a good night to finish.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah. Greg, Greg. Say
that out loud.
Hey, Miles. Hey,
I think I will. I come every year and I don't think I'll stop now either.
There's two of them. Give me, give me, give me.
Are you 100
years
out of
now?
50.
Oh, 50? Nice
shot. It's up and down a lot. Tough course there. Nice course.
What's your name?
Michael McNeena.
And where are you from?
Galway, Terminal King City.
Are you long racing?
About 8 years. 8 years.
Any major prizes?
In the international race in the Isle of Man.
Yeah.
And on the Irish teams the last 2 years.
Yeah.
So. This is my first year senior.
What kind of training do you put in?
Not a lot.
Not a lot?
Not a lot this year. I had a few exams on and stuff.
Yeah.
This is my teammate here then that helped me during the race.
Do you think he's a good racer?
It's not bad now.
All right.
Don't be as good as me now, but sure. Nigel Ford.
And you racing with Trevor King?
We started racing about the same time.
And do you put in much training? Either?
About 250 miles a week.
Is that all?
That's only.
And he won a good race there on Tuesday in Ballinan, yeah. Davis Cup. Beautiful cup for us.
Yeah, it's a smashing cup.
Yeah. Are you a senior this year now?
Yeah, senior B, category 2.
Yeah. And did you win any races in that?
An awful lot of seconds, and Tuesday night in Ballinan was my first win.
Yeah. And what do you think of this course here?
It's tough.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it flat or what is it? What's wrong with it?
No, it's undulating, up and down.
Yeah. You don't like that?
Well, it's a tester.
Yeah. How many miles did you race this evening now?
It's 24.
Yeah. What was your average speed per mile?
To be about 26, yeah.
Are you coming back here again next year?
I will.
What's your name?
Laura Dolan.
And how long are you making butter?
All my life. I won't tell you how long that is.
And what's the secret formula?
Mm-hmm.
What's the secret to making
learn
butter?
From your mother.
Yeah. And how do you make it?
You gather the cream. take the cream off the meat, yeah. And you keep it for a few days. You mix it every twice a day,
yeah.
And to be getting sour, and then eventually you'll know when it's ready for churning. Put it in the churn and make it.
And how long does it take to churn?
About 20 to 25 minutes. Yeah.
And how much butter would that make in?
Well, you're supposed to get 7 pounds to a gallon. That's right or not now. Sometimes you will, sometimes you might. Depends on the thickness of the cream.
Yes.
You know, that you get all the cream off the meat.
And how long would it last? Well, how long would butter last without going
out? Oh, well, in the freezer now, I don't know. I put it into the freezer. I think they have opened. I could have it 12 months in the freezer and it's still all right, you know. So I couldn't say offhand how long it would last, you know.
And they see now you have here, you have salted butter and unsalted butter.
That's right, yes. Some people prefer it unsalted.
Yeah.
You know.
Does that stop it? If you salt the butter, does it stop it from going out?
Pardon?
If you salt the butter, put salt in it.
Yes.
Does it stop it? Does it preserve it better?
It probably would, yeah. I'd expect it would.
Next year will be twice.
Yes. But what do you have? Are you long making this?
First aid today.
First aid today making it. Yeah. Oh, I see. Any? Are you going to
produce much of today?
Oh, well, as much as I can now.
10 gallons?
At least.
How much of glass are you charging?
A pound of glass.
A pound of glass? Oh, that's fair enough. He said, is it good stuff, though?
Oh, the very best.
Is it good for a man that has to have a...
bad heart.
A slow sex reaction.
He doesn't know, he hasn't a problem himself. Yeah,
no, no. There's no such problems around here. But a man told me what it was. No. Yeah. But it was very good for that, like, you know. But it was sure, it was sure.
It was guaranteed to work.
Yeah, all guaranteed to work. Yeah. All guaranteed lift.
And good results.
Oh, very good results, yeah.
Well, I'm for it.
Where are you from yourself? Where did you come from?
The Neil.
Oh, the Neil. Oh, oh, that's just down the road.
Both boy at Dublin.
Yeah. Do you have that stuff in the Neil?
No, Jenny, not that I know of.
No. No.
Probably hidden somewhere.
I know. Is it nice?
Yes. Nice and smooth, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Nice as I drank, anyway.
You want to take it in big gold?
Take more than you want.
I'll take another drop. Jenny, I tell you, I fell off my bike here, I was.
Oh, you want
yeah. It is. Take it down. Straight down to the gut.
Yes.
More. No, it's this again. You have the six stomach, Ranson.
You want ice.
You have the six stomach.
Anyone just cutting it all right?
Oh, there is cutting. Oh, yes.
Oh. His name's Rex.
Which of you has bribed the most of? Father, we're...
Oh, we walk on the sideline.
Yeah. Is it true or not that you bribed the referee?
Well, Mike did actually. He's from Carrick Strand.
He gave me the money.
He paid me off.
He's from Carrick Strand.
Hi, John. 50 grand.
Judge has got out, he's the danger man, he won't get this, he's not fit enough. Here comes Julian, he's paid with lots of pubs in Galway. I don't know what it's sucking or what. But he's on the chair to watch him. Oh, now he's dangerous. Oh, what's up with this one of him moving by Sean Gibbons and Tony Nairnley? Sean Gibbons got for the forward pass, fired up to him, will you? Got him for the forward pass and he's got out. I think what's wrong with this Cong team, there's too many of them staying back. But if you move up where the goal is, Sheedy. Jack Sheedy moving up around the wing. He's coming up after O'Connell's tearing up behind him. Very impressive. We have that inside across the judge. Judge is dangerous. Judge is there. The player's trying to see that for a tackle. And a bit of a side spin along with him. Kicking up the field and Brian Connor has it. He's taking the line inside. He has Min loose inside. He's taking it away on his own. He's taking it off an angle. He's passing it to Tony Nairnley. Tony Nairnley has scored. Tony Nairnley has struck the net to the goal. No kissing, lads, no kissing, please. No kissing allowed. Gibbons has gone back and he's got into Mark Judge. Robbie waiting for the long ball. And it's inside. That fairly takes it down after much. Oh, a nice ball. Round. Robbie's coming inside again and he's watching. He said, where's Judge? Where's Judge? He said, out comes the ball, eh? Which of them? Oh, yes, it is one of them. After the roll, that's your back. Now we have it again. Now, John Morton, up you go. Oh, the Lord, did you see that? What a touch. Oh, good luck of this ballerina we got here. Swinging feet everywhere. Oh, give him the out here, yes.
Oh, yes, sir! Pass to the place, he didn't take it on. Bobby is coming in on the inside. Watching Arthur Connor moves out and he's waiting for the chip to burn. Another point for Ashford. I don't think these two goalies are going to move at all. They're going to stay in the same goal. Has anyone got a care, Arthur? We can bring them down the other end.
From the middle of the pitch, ready to take this kick off. The priest waves, he sets everybody in order. We're away in a heck again. Paul McGrath moves up and on the wing. Brian Connor strikes it inside to him. Oh, what a move! Oh, he's battling the ball. Oh, the Lord God, Arthur is down again. Dennis is moving upside. Oh, we have an over swing here. There's 2 men inside. John Morton sweeps it out. He passes to the wrong man. Lord Thurman has it. He takes a shot and another point for Ashford. 3 points to Gibbons fires it across Tony Bailey, then Prime is there. And we take another shot and I watch the movement. And yes, sir, we got another with the incitement up here. Paul takes a sweep, who shot inside to Brian. Michael John is out. Dalton puts it out over the line. Inside Michael Crow, Seamus Judge. And up goes the goalie, what a save, and Brian Connor sweeps it out. And it's gone again, Tony Varney's away in a hack. We have a man in front, passing up five, and Sean Gibbons away in a hack. Tony Varney's there, and he still has to take it up, and then line ball. Gibbons in here, he's roaring and shouting for him. The ball is fired in, there he is, Gibbons, looking at him, then Arthur to clap him. Oh, he's got it to his own man, and he's down. But Arthur's on the way over the time today. One yellow card. Now we're away. Seamus Judge, he's there. Lord Turner puts the head down. And we're off the ball. Another point for Ashford. Thank you, Sean. Oh, it's not the wrong man. This is there to defend him again. He's taking it up. Moves it in, shuffles it fairly well. After it's defended for a minute. That's all right. The reason you know that's where the Barnett! Yes! Here you go, Brian, inside. Get the head down! Penalty! It has to be a penalty! Oh, it has to be, it has to be! Could not the nets for the penalty! Brought down in the box! The stop! Tony, where are you? Yes, Tony! Oh, it has to be a penalty!
All over, Johnny.
Try and get over it.
Best side one. Not right, lad. Chris from Orange.
We had a good commentary shot. We ran out of petrol. Huh? She's gonna go. I guess she's got her reasons, but I just don't want to know. Because for 24 years I've been living next door. So have a
side reason. 24 years just waiting for a chance to tell her how I feel and maybe hear the singing there. Now I've got it, baby, you and I and you will get your own. The golf is where.
Did you have some bombs in the house for the walls? I don't know what the mic's in the
used to play in a group, you know, and with us ago, I played with him. We were part of a group called the Symbolics. I was Sim. Anyway, now, listen, we'll get on with it. What I'd like you to do is to give a little round of applause for our judges tonight. We've got 3 judges for you from different walks of life and different parts of life. We've got Councillor Michael Bourke, all the way from Ballinrobe. We've got Maura Lydon, who is now titled Milady Corrup, which was a festival that was run in Clonmore. And for all the festivals that's advertised on Midwest Radio, there's a fellow up there that puts the screws on you for the few pounds and quotes you the rates and You know, he's not a bad little fella at all. He's called Martin McHugh. And I'm sure lots of you have spoken to him on the phone, so give him a big round of applause. They're tucked away in the corner where no one can see them, I think. But anyway, they've been with the girls all day. And the interview itself here on stage is really going to let you meet them and see what you think. But really, they've been with the judges all day. They've been out with us for a couple of hours, and we've enjoyed their company. So I think, without any further ado, we're going to start and kick it off. And I tell you what I'd love you to do now is, the first and the last is always the very hardest. So give a big, big, enthusiastic round of applause, and lots of quiet, right? For our first girl, Gillian Hopkins. Would that be your ideal man?
Oh, definitely.
It would.
Definitely, yeah.
Okay. Right, Gillian. Gillian, you're 18 years of age. Okay, you've just left school. All right, you're finished studying. What, tell us part of your studies yourself that you like most. Shh, I'm a bit quiet, please.
I'd say it would have to be languages, and hopefully in the future I'd like to travel. Ideally, when I get my Leaving Cert results, I'd like to get European studies. That way, it would be part of the course, and I'd be able to travel then along with that, as well as do my studies in college.
Yeah. Lads, it's very hard. There's a lady representing Ryan's and Kong, Malvina Holian. Fighting over you already, look at that. Huh? They kept the escort back. No, how are you? Are you well?
That's
have you enjoyed the day so far?
Oh yeah.
You're from the Derrys in Cross. Anyone here? Are you all here from the Derrys, we are? She just finished school, she's age 17, and what would you like to do? To 40 year studies, and what would you like to do to go on? What's your ambitions in life?
I got a straight course, tourism skills, to do that in October.
Okay. So, after that, where would you like to see yourself going from there?
I don't know really. I haven't really thought it that far ahead.
Alright. Well, you like? A very, very similar, right, I suppose, up the road, about a quarter of a mile from where that lady was from. It's again from the Delhis, but representing O'Malley's. Would you give a nice big round of applause, please, for Dorothy Walsh. Good evening. Stand in close to that and we have a chat. Okay. How are you?
Not so bad, man. Not so bad.
Okay. You alright? Okay. Now, Dorothy walks in Ashford Castle. I'd say there's a few gang down from Ashford Castle here, there is. Alright. She tells me that she'd like, and I suppose in times to come, to work a reception work eventually in hotels. Why is that?
Because mostly because I've been working with people for a long time, so I'd like to work hopefully in reception at one stage.
What about when you get people in, there obviously people very hard to hear. What about people that would be awkward? An awkward young. Give me an awkward young. Or an awkward Italian.
Take his wallet and throw him in the car.
Take his what?
His wallet.
His wallet. Alright, I wasn't sure. Hey, contestant number four is Karen Malahi, and she's representing O'Connor's here in Cork. Give her a big round of applause. I'm told it's extremely hard, and our judges are very close to the stage, to hear. So could you bear with me, please? I've asked you before, just give us a small little bit of quiet. Yeah. How are you?
Hi.
Are you well?
Fine, thanks.
So isn't as bad as we thought, sure, is it?
No, it wasn't.
Okay, now, you turn the small little bit this way to me and just face it in the microphone. Okay. Will be lovely, okay? I'm told, according to yourself here, that you're just finished school and you're going to do a secretarial course.
That's right, yeah. Okay.
What have you got in mind and what type of a course?
It's a secretarial course in school. And afterwards, I'm at the hotel reception in Kilimanjaro or somewhere else.
Okay. Well, why hotel reception? What's your attraction to hotel work?
Because I like office work and I like to meet people and hotel. I like hotel work.
Ladies and gentlemen, is representing Danners and Kong. Would you welcome, please, Karen O'Neill. Round of applause, I tell you, to cheer for that. This is the tallest lady, I suppose, yet to me. Huh? I remember her when she was small too, but anyway, she's the tallest lady I have. Now, I'm told you just finished a secretarial course.
In Galway.
In Galway?
Yeah.
In where?
Mayrant College in Galway.
Right, and I'm told, and listen to this, for a petite young lady like her, she would like to go and join the Garda Síochána. Could you imagine trying to say no to that lady giving you a parking ticket or a speeding fine or telling you that you had two or three too many? I could never, if you don't mind me saying so, see you as the vanguard. You're too pleasant and too polite.
No, I'd be totally different. No, I'm not.
Are you vicious?
Yes, very.
You were stationed now in Galway, say, right, and you did become a vanguarder. And you met one of the lads coming home here around from Kong or, say, the Neil or somewhere like that, and he was speeding. Yeah. Would you be hard on him?
Yeah. Very. Oh, yeah. They hate me.
They hate you. And what is it that excites you most, we'd say, about being a vanguarder?
Something different about it all the time. Yeah. It's never a dull moment, and I just love the uniform.
Love the uniform. Thank you, Roscommon. Would you welcome, please, Sharon Drury. You're telling me earlier on that you work in Ashford Castle.
Yeah, right? I work there since
age 2. Right, yeah. What does your work involve in Ashford Castle? What do you do?
Well, at the moment I'm doing hotel and catering management in Galway. So I finished working in the restaurant and I'm working in the kitchen now as chef for 3 months until October. And then I go back to college again.
So we'll be okay for a fry in the morning?
No problem for a fry.
Anybody wants breakfast in the morning, Ashford Castle, Sharon Drury is cooking. Ladies Lodge, Sinead Moran. They tell me that blondes have it very, very easy in life and they're always fellas running after them. Is that true?
No.
No. I haven't seen a blind man around town yet though. I mean, I don't stand into the mic. Okay? It's not true. Your address here says that you're from Craigray in Kong, County Mayo, but I don't think that was the real address, is it?
No, that's not the original address. I'm from Dublin originally.
There you are. I'm not on my own. I have got two of us here tonight now already. Originally from Dublin.
Yeah.
Well, welcome to Kong. Great to have another Dublin around here anyway. And we've Tom Devereaux, of course, as well, you know, out from Neil there, so not too bad. We're not alone. Tell us, what made you come from Dublin down to Kong to live?
My father is from Kong,
August come down here on holidays. And it's always my dream to live down here, and at the age of 18, I came to live in Cong.
18. 25 years ago. Right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm told that the judges, we can have your attention, please. They have a result for us. And what I'd like to do is call the girls back up on stage. Gillian Hopkins. Elvina Holin. Dorothy Walsh. Karen Malahi. Caroline O'Neill. Sharon Drury. And Sinead Moran. Give them a nice big round of applause. Small technicalities take place. Patrick Lydon is going to come up on behalf of the committee and he's going to present and read out, I think, for me, the results. Is that right, Pat? We're also going to ask Laura Lydon to join us on stage and present the bouquet and flowers to the winner. She has the Laura is, I'm sure for those of you that were in Clonbur at the Easter weekend, Maura is titled now for us Milady Corrib, and she represented Galway this year in a festival in Balbriggan which is called Milady Erin. Briefly, that is a festival for people that are involved in community work over the age of 35. So it's really, she's just about over the age of 35. It's really a festival for young roses or elderly roses of Tralee, but anyways, that's all right. Now, Maureen Varney, I think, let's give her a big, big round of applause. Come on, she's put a big walk into this. Come up here and join us, come on. Up you go. It's always smashing to see these are nice the way they turn out, but behind it all, as I said earlier on, there's a lot of work goes into it. And I don't think, really, a lot of people understand the amount of work goes in to get festivals like this together. And there's a big committee in Cong, and I think they've done extremely well. It's lovely to see them all here tonight. Patrick Lydon, where are you? I think I was okay to call him that. I'm not too sure. I know him a minute. Come over here to me. He's going to say a few words to you now. If I couldn't keep you quiet. You get a foot off of that. If I couldn't keep you quiet, by Jesus, you listen to this fella. I'll tell you that anyway, because he's bigger than me. I give you over to Patrick Lydon. Patrick is, I think, the vice chairman of the festival committee here. Give him a round.
Ladies and gentlemen, all I can say to you, thank you, and thanks Paddy Rock and the judges for all they have done to this, and thank you very much. And thanks to Matt for the music and the also. And Maura Lydon now is going to give the presentation.
Now, is everybody ready to listen this time? This is a very important announcement, and before I make it, I have to say that I think the girls had a very difficult task in trying to talk to Paddy over the noise, and I think every one of them deserves a medal for the way they behaved. Unfortunately, there's only one winner, and she will go on from here into the next competition, which is Queen of the Mask. The decision was very difficult, but it was unanimous. and the marking was very close. And I want the people at the back to hear as well. The winner is from Kong.
Congratulations and celebrations. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. Congratulations and celebrations. And I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Who would believe that I'd be happy and contented? I used to think that happiness was just invented. I used to dream about it. Celebrations, I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. Right, everyone knows this song.
Ladies and gentlemen, your festival queen for 1995, Caroline O'Neill.
The pale moon was rising above.
Thank you.
shoulder from him and burst around him. Checking over Shimmer's down. Healy could be a bit of trouble here. He seems to go on a carry. He's got a poor ball on my word. Healy's got a poor ball.
That's it for DBR.
Oh,
I find it looking for the name.
Yeah.
Loudspeaker.
I want the loudspeaker, the microphone.
Say hello to the girl. Say hello.
Go in. You're her agent.
It's the beer side. It's that clean cider. Especially when you mix it with Bacardi. It has a strange effect early in the morning. I hope you're not a horsey.
Completely free. Free of anything.
What are you doing? Stick it on your
head. Yeah, got it. Right.
Near the back of the tree.
That's a mess now.
Wave to camera, Shelly.
You're on camera, so you should smile.
Who are you?
Lorraine.
What are you dressed as?
Mr. Farmer's wife.
And where's the farmer?
He's Mr. and Mrs. Brown here.
Oh. No?
I come around to see you. Look at his face.
And who are you?
Miss Carr.
Miss Carr.
You'll have us in the paper.
Good man, take these two lads in. Don't leave out these lads.
I think the boys are left. I wrote it in.
Mommy, baby.
You're going to smile. I'll have to smile in a minute. Oh, you don't. You didn't put it on me. That's a joke. You're embarrassing me. That's a joke. Come on, girls. We'll move on.
Look in there. Look here. Look
at that. Hiya.
Say hiya.
Come on, give a big smile.
What? Give a big smile.
And Terry Riley, always pressing, but they don't seem to be putting it on the board in the last 10 minutes.
Yes, but the way that we really have so much time with the ball, that...
RTE.
I'll throw out your tongue and do something at them.
Umbra, umbra.
Look,
bye-bye.
Say bye-bye, John.
I'm going in the bone of the
Wait till I fix her and you can lead her around and then I just keep it.
Sinead.
And in second place, number 5.
No, thank you. Well done.
What's the child's name?
Gerard.
Gerard
O'Malley.
O'Malley.
Yeah. Thank you. And in third place, number 3. A little Dolly.
Well done. Monroe, wasn't that the name I know?
And that's a little certificate.
Three I would love to take home with. So in third place, I'd definitely go for number 9. Now, lovely baby.
Number 9.
Number 9.
There you go. Thanks. It's Stephen Mark.
In second place, number 5. Shitty girl. And in first place, number 1.
Thank you very much.
That's right.
Thank you very much.
You're so kind. Look at those. I got your certificate.
Will you give me your
certificate? Oh, I did. One of the kids has it. Thank you very much.
Now.
Cheers.
Once upon a time, now we never seem to rock and roll anymore. I was yours and you were mine. That was once upon a time.
We'd like to visit just one second. We have the winners of the Bunny Baby competition. And the first category is category A, that's not 12-month-old babies. And we'll go in anti-clockwise, you might call it. In third place is Sinead Wiggins. In second place is Gerard O'Malley. And the winner of category A is Hayley Munro. Can a big hand there for Hayley Munro, please? Thank you. Winner of category A. Hayley, you know here in this way.
You can drink that out of the water.
If you would have heard us. And in category B, the winner is an anti-clockwise order again. It doesn't work for him. In third place, Robert Biggins, winner of category B in the non-gaming competition.
She's getting married in 2 weeks' time, leave her alone, she'll have enough of the
I'm very nervous. I don't know who she's going to
suck the back.
That's my legs.
Customer all day yesterday as well.
We'll do the next one for Pamela McGrath, who I'm told is in love with Henry Burton. Is that right? Matt?
I know.
Every Sunday please got to think about you. You see a man walk down the street, looks at me and he smiles so sweet. It don't matter to me, come think about you. Every little dream I dream about you, every little thought I think about you. Time is crazy when we go away, you like pop. Thank you.
bridges. There's Kaylee down there now.
Oh my God.
Thank you.